Hello, everybody. We're at Mount Everest Base Camp here at 17,000 feet. We've been here for a little over 2 weeks, high on the mountain, getting acclimatized for our summit push. As you can tell, we've got a little growth going here and looking pretty nasty, to say the least. But we're going to spend about 4 or 5 more days down here before we head back up to try for our summit push. Excuse me, I'll be right back. Hello guys, I'm back again. I had to clean up if I was going to give you a good tour of base camp here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spend some time and walk around. I'll show you what base camp is all about, where we sleep, where we eat, where we just hang out, and a bunch of other good stuff. So enjoy the show. Hello everybody. This is what Mount Everest Base Camp looks like. It's a very vast area of land. You can see the different tents, different teams that are set up here. Our camp is right here. Way off in the distance is the Chinese camp. They're a very, very large camp. Looking way out here at the gorgeous Mount Everest. There's the tip of it. Hopefully in a couple weeks we'll be standing right on top. Right there. And then again, this is what base camp looks like. Surrounded by big mountains. There's the Rumbuk Valley River. Right there. Just a beautiful place. Here's some deer here in base camp. I think they're called blue sheep, but there they go. There's a lot of wildlife around here. Birds, sheep, some dogs, yaks.
This is the memorial for Mallory and Irvin, two very famous British climbers who were lost on Everest in 1924, and there's still some controversy as to whether or not they may or may not have made the summit, which obviously would have been a long time before Tenzing and Henry. But most people think they probably didn't. And Mallory's body was actually found in 1999 by an American expedition high on the mountain. And this is the memorial to both of them.
This right here is my tent, my living quarters. I'm gonna show you what it's like inside, nothing major. Got some food in the white bucket here. And as I pan in here, this is where I sleep. You see it's kind of a mess. Got some clothes hanging up to dry out, air out. This is my tent, or my sleeping bag and my sleeping pad. Nothing major, but this is home for now. Now, if you decide to do laundry at base camp, this is how you do it. Gavin's taking his stinky drawers that he hasn't washed in about 3 weeks, and let's put them in a bucket. Any words of wisdom here for your laundry doing, Gavin?
Oh, no, just it's good to get some clothes that don't stink real soon when these dry.
Stink or stand up in the corner of your tent on their own, right?
Let's see what this. This is a sock that I've been wearing for at least 3 weeks. I've hiked in it, slept in it, and it's about as clean as it's gonna get.
There you have it. Laundry at base camp, Mount Everest. All right, this is our kitchen tent here. This is where all the guys, the great cooks, we got Sergey here cooking. This is where everything takes place. What do you wanna say here, Sergey?
Yeah, I'm Sergey.
And what are you making today for us?
I'm making the I made already some beds here.
Right.
And now I'm heading to make the finger chips for the lunch. And
how long have you been cooking for expedition, Sergey?
I have experience 6-7 years.
6-7 years. You're the best cook on the mountain, right?
Yeah, yeah. and I had experience with this Jamie 3 years. This Jamie's group.
Excellent. And who are your friends over here?
Yeah, these are all from the Tibetans.
Right.
I'm from the Tibet for the kitchen helper.
And what is your name?
His name is Dorji.
Dorji?
Dorji Gelgen.
Okay, and your name?
Danuru.
Alright, well, we appreciate all your guys' help.
Is Danuru is from the borderland.
Okay.
And Dorji is one of the place of the Tingri.
Tingri?
Yeah, Tingri.
Alright, well, thanks, guys.
Welcome to.
Bye bye. Oh!